Even George II's firework displays didn't go without a hitch. The king had forked out £8,000, about £1 million today. But with a crowd of 12,000 people waiting, the decorated frame holding the fireworks caught fire. The designer wasn't happy, and the hapless fireworker ended up with a sword at his throat. By the 1900s, the political power of the royals had eroded, but show was as important to them as ever. They were still the people to know, sharing their lavish lifestyle with their favoured movers and shakers. An invite to one of Edward VII's shooting parties at Sandringham was the ultimate social accolade, and every guest wanted to look their very best. Which brings me to my next worst job, which is very much at the bottom of the pecking order, literally below stairs. It's the boot boy. Edward loved shooting, and he worked his guests hard. They'd spend long days blasting away at wildlife before returning late for a lavish dinner, port, cigars and bed. As the snores broke out over Sandringham, the royal boot boy's day was only just beginning. And it was up to the poor old boot boy to creep around the corridors last thing at night, collecting up everyone's boots and shoes and then polishing them so they'd be bright and shiny for the hunt the next morning. And given that King Edward insisted that the entire hunting party should be up at the crack of dawn and everyone had to set their alarms really early, the poor old boot boys hardly got any sleep at all. So, Edward VII's upstairs. He's brought his full hunting party with him. How much work is that going to be for me, the boot boy?
A horrific amount of work. When the hunting was going on, chaps like you really did have a rough life.
Right, I've got the shoelaces out. What next?
You've got to learn how to make your own blacking. If you come round here, yep. I'm going to read you Mrs. Beaton's recipe for blacking. Are you ready?
Yep.
Take 4 ounces of ivory black. God, that looks good stuff. then 1 ounce of olive oil.
How many of these am I putting in?
The grim side of this job wasn't just terrible tiredness, but also mixing up some pretty foul and caustic ingredients, which could be deadly.
We've got 1 ounce of sulfuric acid. This one you'd be very careful of. I think I'd better do this for you. Hold your nose.
Yeah. Oh, we're going to die.
Oh, rotten eggs?
You bet. Whoa. How much did they get paid?
About £8 a year, which wasn't very much, but then they did get their keep. So most of that £8, their mother would expect them to bring back home to them on their monthly day off.
Always be good to your mum.
In times of earlier monarchs, working for the king or queen could bring you riches. But by the 20th century, backbreaking royal domestic service wasn't even well paid.
By Edward VII's time, most young men at that time didn't want to go into domestic service. They wanted to go into something much more glamorous and manly, like the army, and march out to the colonies in their red coats. So domestic service was beginning to be really looked down on. So when you did get your very rare days off, you'd go out there and people would jeer at you rather for coming from a house rather than coming from some job in the new industries that were growing up.
It's a pretty scant reward for doing all this work, but nevertheless, it's enough to get the boots polished up. I'm rather proud of that, even if they do stink of sugar.
And it didn't stop at hunting boots. There were all the party shoes to shine as well. And by the time those were done, the hunter's boots were back again. But at least one of my jobs had an end to it.
What with all the falls and the ambushes, not to mention losing my lovely hat and having to ride about 200 miles just to deliver a simple message, that job is frightening, dangerous, not to say very, very tedious. But my very worst royal job is also extremely disgusting. Oh, and now, of course, I've got to ride all the way back again.
Come on, Poppy, off we go.
I've been looking at the worst jobs that supported the monarchy down the centuries. But which one was the very worst job? Moving house for Elizabeth I was backbreaking, but pretty well paid. Fireworking was fun, so long as you remembered to keep your head out of the way.
Whoa, blimey!
And even royal falconers had a family firm to support them when they were old codgers.
Oh, does that count?
No, for me, the very worst job of all is an incredibly disgusting and very ancient one, and one that underlies the very symbol of royalty itself, the purple maker. Purple has been the colour of royalty since Roman emperors, because it's so difficult and expensive to make.